started mathematics in Freiburg, in the south of Germany. And then in the middle I went for 1 year with an Erasmus exchange to Lyon. And back then finished my diploma in Freiburg. And after that I went for my PhD to Leipzig. And this is actually where I then started to work on some Blackley geometry and dynamical systems. And then for my PhD I switched into dynamics and some Blackley geometry. Then I went for 6 months to Israel. And then I was for 1 year at the MSI in Berkeley. After that, I've been for 1 year in Stanford, before I moved for another half a year to the IIS in Princeton. After that, I've been for 3 years as a postdoc in Lausanne at the EPFL, before in February 2015, I moved here to Antwerp in Belgium. Complex geometry existed since, 200 years. It has a bunch of, symmetry or rigidity properties, but this new geometry had more of them, so we needed a new word, and therefore one took then the Greek version, symplectic. And to relate the dynamics to symplectic geometry, they have in particular conservation laws, and certain things have also special symmetries, and one can demonstrate it by such a top, where one easily can see that this movement conserves symmetries. When I'm not sleeping, I'm either doing mathematics or climbing. I like it very much because on the one hand, one has to concentrate fully on it. You need strength, but you also need coordination. You need a very good way to balance your body weight, and everything together is, I just enjoy it. It's very nice. It's some kind of art and not just sport. I think it's also very rewarding to see then when students actually like your topic and think it's fun and come then to ask for a bachelor or master thesis or something like this. Because, I mean, this proves that you managed to convey the message the right way, I think. I'm getting more and more involved with more applied topics. In pure math, you work with things and a priori you don't know if it even exists. So, I would like to have a good connection and interplay between the pure techniques and the applied problems, because one gives a boost to the other usually.